Hi everyone, Alfred here. It's December 24th, 2008, Christmas Eve morning. I'm in South Florida. Let's do the quick weather check. It's a gray day in South Florida, but the temperature is about in the mid-70s. So it's still absolutely nice. And what do I bring you this morning? I bring you part two of the Christmas Wrap 2008 video. Come on, let's go wrap some gifts. Instead of wrapping gifts, maybe we should wrap JPEGs. Wow, that was a really bad joke. And the first one from this film. Phlegm. Film. Whatever. Okay, here we go. Christmas Wrap 2008. I was walking down the street with a girl in my arm. Alright, replay on the bad jokes, whatever. Alright, let me show you the first gift. Here it is. Look at this. For cousin Teresa and Alex. Oh, how they love Halloween stuff. Tim Burton's Nightmare Before Christmas. It's a motion-activated life-size talking bust. Technically, Tommy Lee having some fun with Pamela Anderson between her breasts, that would make Pamela Anderson a motion-activated life-size talking bust. What do you want? You want wholesome family videos? Don't come here. Go to the freaking Disney Channel. Let's go wrap this thing.
All right, now here's a quick sign joke before I wrap this thing. Instead of Nightmare Before Christmas, how about just the Mare Before Christmas?
And that would be a movie about a couple that enjoys having animal sex on Christmas Eve with a horse. Wow, that was a really bad joke. Let's wrap this thing, really, because the jokes are going to keep flowing. Flow.
Okay, so the gift is centered around Nightmare. Nightmare, we think of the U.S. economy. We're going to make this an Obama wrap. Boy, this guy got a really tough job ahead of him. Really, God bless him, and everyone, you better support him.
And do you want to see the final work of art? The final Obama wrap? Here it is. It came out pretty good.
And look at how nice this came out. It's totally festive, totally American, and eco-friendly. So there we have it, an official Obama wrap. Nice. And Julian is going to get an FF class Tonka truck. This is pretty cool. And it's for ages 3 plus. This is going to be a tough one to wrap. It's a pretty large gift, so
I don't know. I'm just going to, like, wrap it with wrapping paper. Nothing really off the wall crazy. I'll do the best I can. Really. Yeah, sure. And what do they say when they're picking up Rosie O'Donnell's buffet lunch?
Let's load them up and move on out.
We do have a little bit of a mechanical engineering challenge because the width of the gift is wider than the paper. Now, obviously, I could reorient the gift.
But no, that would be too smart. Let's try to wrap it this way and then see how lousy it can come out. You see, with this wrap job, I truly only wrapped the present. You really don't know what the present is, so it's still a surprise. And it's also eco-friendly because I only wrapped what needed to be wrapped. And it looks pretty good. Take a look.
So there it is. What we call a tree-saving partial wrap. And it came out quite nice. The child is still surprised, and
somewhere, maybe New Jersey, we've saved a tree. Whatever.
Ah, and for Gabriella, my little vortex of evil, I got her this incredible, cool, talking parrot. Does the freaking thing work? It says, try me. Let's see. Wave over my head and wave again. Come on, talk, you piece of crap.
Hello!
Yeah, there you go. Hello! Polly wanna quacka? Is that all you do?
Pretty damn impressive. More computer processing power than the lunar module had when it landed on the moon in the 60s. Unless it was faked. All right, new wrapping technique here. Let me show you what I'm doing with the damn parrot.
This wrap job is called a coffin wrap because this thing won't shut the F up. Shut up. Oh, Jesus H. Christ. And the H is for help me. This thing won't shut up. Shut up. That's better. I think this thing's alive. You knock it off. I'm gonna wrap you now. I hope your light sensor doesn't get pissed off.
Hello.
Yeah, hello, you too. Whatever. A little bit of a... Oh, God damn it. All right, let me just bio-seal this thing. All right, maybe a hefty wrap on top of it. Hey, this is looking pretty festive, this coffin wrap with the industrial gorilla duct tape. I just gotta cover up the...
Hello.
Yeah, shut up. Tell it to knock it off. Ah, oh, all right, here goes the song again. You know, you're really freaking annoying. Can you say sham wow? Sham wow.
And here is the finished product, the coffin wrap. And again, the actual gift is out of sight of the child's eyes. There it is, very nice. And of course, we, as a little festive touch, we do put some industrial gorilla duct tape on the packaging. And again, eco-friendly, green. We're making use of the old Amazon.com box. Really, does it get any better than this?
Hello.
Coffin wrap, 2008. Nice. Oh, and I have a little extra gift for Gabriella, my little vortex of evil. Now you might ask, why do I call this child my vortex of evil? I'll tell you why. Because at a family party, she had asked me, she requested that I wear black contact lenses on Christmas Eve.
Gabriella, on Christmas Eve, do you want me to wear the scary white contact lenses?
No, white. The black ones.
You want me to wear the black contact lenses? I don't have black contact lenses. I thought you liked the white ones.
I don't like them. I want the black ones.
You want me to wear black eyes? You mean scary ones?
Like the witch.
You like them? You like the scary ones? Oh, my little vortex of evil, you're so cute.
Sham wow. Let me show you what else I got her.
Okay, to demonstrate the yin and yang, the balance between good and evil, we have the very good holiday Christmas Barbie, and we have the evil Halloween Barbie. Good and evil.
New wrapping technique. We're going to turn this into a lesbian Barbie wrap. Let me show you.
You might ask, how do I turn this into a lesbian Barbie wrap? We just reorient the gifts like this. There it is, folks. Lesbian Barbie wrap. Nice. And here we have the completed lesbian Barbie wrap. There's a little bit of overhang. But nothing too critical, really. Wow, this really came out pretty nasty. The kids, as they get older, they're gonna get a real laugh when they see these videos and realize how crappy I wrapped gifts. But it's the thought that counts.
Not only is it the thought that counts, but certainly the fact that I am taking the time to wrap these as best as I can. You think you can do better? Prove me wrong. Post some video responses. Let me see how you wrap gifts. Really. Knock it off. Oh, and for little baby Sabrina, I got her an artificially intelligent Elmo toy. Check this one out.
Elmo just wanted to say that Elmo loves you. Mm-hmm.
Wow, that's pretty impressive. You know, they have an Asian hooker version of this toy where when you press the button, it says, I love you long time, $5. Sorry about that one. Okay, I'm gonna mod the gift. I am truly going to make this into an Asian Elmo hooker wrap. Watch.
One modded gift that's really gonna confuse the hell out of people. Looks like she fits right into that box. Perfect. So this came out pretty good, the Asian Elmo hooker wrap. Not that much overhang. And like I said, it's gonna surprise the hell out of people when they open this thing up. Whatever.
As part of my holiday shoplifting activities in 2008, I did stop into Radio Shack. Yes, indeed, the great Radio Shack, which was the reseller of the TRS-80 microcomputer back in the day, the Trash 80. Post a comment if you remember that system or if you had that system. Let me show you what I got for little Vincenzo.
I got him a tribot. There it is, the tribot, who I guess is trisexual, which means
that he would try anything. Let's wrap it. I gotta pick up the pace on this wrap job because I'm getting late, as usual. For the bot, it's getting wrapped. Sometimes I have trouble with words. It's getting wrapped in a freaking hefty bag. Now, I've pioneered this before a few years ago. You know, just a basic hefty bag wrap, but who says you can't use it again? Here we go.
Oh, the little bot, you're getting bagged. It's a tri-bot. Yeah, it's a tri-bot bag wrap. There it is. Real simple.
Now I'm just going to put on the industrial strength network tie, and it's done. Nice.
The Radio Shack salesman upsold me some batteries so that the tri-bot system can work when it's unwrapped. Am I going to include them?
No! Let the parents buy something for a change. I'm not putting the freaking batteries in. I'm going to keep them so I can put them in my Wiimote. So I can play Animal Crossing. That's a shout out to you, Dave. You know I don't even have that freaking game. God.
And, of course, the finished product. Look at how nice that looks with the red bow. I mean, the red bow against on top of the black bag. I mean, it just looks so great and so festive. And notice here, look. The industrial strength network tie. Just for added festivities. Now, normally you think I would cut this, right? Normally someone would cut that extra overhang, that excess here.
I say nay, nay. That excess wire wrap will stay there. You know why? Because some of the little brats are going to be poking around the Christmas tree looking at gifts, and that could potentially poke someone in the eye. Then we can make a Christmas Eve hospital run, and oh, what fun it is to ride to a hospital on Christmas Eve. That would make some good footage. So it stays. Ho, ho, ho. Whatever. Cousin Rich is running out of hard disk storage on his Mac Pro system. Must be too much Asian porn. So, I caught a good deal on a 500 gigabyte Hitachi drive from Otherworld Computing. So I'm giving him a hard drive, a 500 gig hard drive. And I'm gonna wrap it in this.
The box for a Mac Mini. This wrap job is so easy, it's almost scary. There we go. With a little bit of protection. Always wear protection. Of course, hard to do with one hand. But the other hand's on the camera. Knock it off. All right, there it is. Is it? Beautiful and quite functional. So the bow covered up the M, so it's an Ack Mini. But there it is. Mac Mini Porn Storage Wrap. I think it looks really, really good. And once again, the signature Gorilla duct tape. That's definitely a sign of Alfred.
This is simple. For Aunt Fran, one of those precious moment pieces, and it's a Neiman Marcus bag wrap. Real easy. Here we go.
Some things you just gotta do quick. And done.
And yes, to add to the festive nature of this particular gift,
I did add industrial strength staples. Just to give it a little extra oomph, a little extra twang, and to make it a little bit harder for the senior family members to open up the gift. There it is. The Neiman Marcus wrap. Nice. Now here's a nice precious moments piece from my cousin Rich's wife, Madeline. All right, now what makes this particular piece interesting is the extra cost for the damn Walt Disney brand.
Snow White. She slept with all freaking seven dwarfs. That hua.
And once again, the finished product, the Snow White is a whore wrap. Nice.
Senior family member Nancy is also getting a precious moments piece, which I'm dropping in this box.
Harry and David. Real simple. One and a two and a three. Bing. Done.
Like I bought something from Harry and David. I say nay, nay. I got this box of food goodies from my private banker. You know how much money I lost with this guy? He sends me a box of Harry and David crap. I'm pissed. I am. Now Nancy, at 80 years of age, does suffer from some terrible arthritis in her hands. So what did I do? I put extra industrial packing tape on this package. Ha ha!
And here we have the finished product, the investment Banker Screwed Me Wrap. Nice.
And a very special gift for Alyssa.
My little angel of death.
That's right, for Alyssa. She's the one that thought it was pretty funny when I put Gianna's Scooby-Doo sweatshirt in a box and gave it to her as a special gift from Santa.
Oh, you think I got it? You think I wrapped a sweater from last year?
That was funny.
For Alyssa, I'm doing something extremely special.
Alyssa is getting a Wii system. However,
in the box for the Wii is not going to be a Wii. It's got a piece of Claxton fruitcake is what I'm stuffing in the box. And you know what I'm going to do with the Wii? I'm going to put the Wii in this box.
The box of a 23-inch FF class iMac.
She'll get the Wii, open it up, there's going to be a piece of freaking fruitcake in there. Then I'm going to give her her real gift, which will be the iMac box. And she'll say, oh, I'm getting an iMac. I say, nay, nay, you're getting a Wii. You better be freaking happy with it. That's a nice gift. Here we go with the wrap.
Part one and part two of the Wii have been exorcised from the box. And here's that demo DVD or whatever the hell format they use for from that catalog that I used to wrap Dave's gift. All right, so there's the Wii. Here's a freaking Wii box. Oh, we're going to stuff some fruitcake in there, haha. Oh, look at the fine cinematography and the foreshadowing I'm doing here with the iMac box beautifully aligned in the background. Here we have one brick of Claxton fruitcake, which I happen to like. I'm going to put the URL. It's good. It's good. I eat this stuff. And here it goes. Wow, that thing's heavy. Oh, it's sitting just nice in there. Oh, boy, she is really going to be pretty pissed off when she opens this freaking thing. Good. Is this gorgeous or what? I think a psychotic mass murderer could probably do a better rap job. And this is what I call a yummy rap, since there's a freaking Claxton fruitcake inside the Wii box. Okay, the Wii system has been successfully deposited and stapled into an Armani bag. Industrial strength staples are deployed in this wrapping. Now, insertion in to the iMac box. I gotta make a little more room on the bottom, but yeah, this is, yeah, beautiful. Nice, it fits just, it's perfect! Look at that! Perfect, beautiful. I put a little extra packaging material in there just to buffer it so it doesn't get knocked around, and consider this done! And the final wrap job on the iMac box is truly a work of art. Let me show you. There it is. To Alyssa from Uncle Al, your real gift wrap. Nice. Now what I did here was that there's a little hint of the Apple logo. She's not a dope. She's going to think, oh my goodness, there's an iMac in there, but probably not. All right, so we do have a little bit of a hint. Industrial packing tape once again. Very important and very festive. And of course, it's a functional box. I let the handle shine through. Is she gonna burst out into tears when she opens up the Wii box and sees a freaking Claxton brick of fruitcake in there? I hope so. And maybe I'll be filming, so stay tuned. And for Gianna, I'm getting her a few video games. Now, I got her an Xbox 360 for her birthday, but I'll show you some games I'm getting her as well. I got her the Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix game. I also got her Animal Crossing for the freaking Wii, well, a Nintendo DS. And here's something she's probably not familiar with. I got her a book, so when she's not playing video games, she can read. That's right. A lost art these days with the younger kids. Read a book. Nice industrial staples for the 8-year-old. And I call this the Looks Like Halo gift wrap. Am I right? Beautiful. Dave, one of my family members, he's married to Madeline. They also just had their second baby, and he was also the Marine. You know, we had Dave's rock band party video. Anyway, Dave's Xbox 360 red ringed. He bought a new one, so to kick it off, I'm getting him and her Prince of Persia. Yeah, they like this game. It's a lot of fun, and I'm going to give him a little boost for the new baby that they had. So that will be wrapped in one little package, and it will look like crap. Watch. I'm sorry, the word aluminium doesn't sit well with me. It doesn't work. A special apology to all my UK subscribers. I can't say aluminium. I gotta say aluminum. Aloom. A-L-O-O-M. Loom. Min. M-I-N-U-M. Aluminum. Right, we say it wrong. Aluminium. No, it's aluminum. Whatever. It's aluminum! Aluminum. Bagel. Aluminum. Who gives a crap, okay? A quick sneak preview. I'm really having trouble speaking these days. A quick sneak preview. For my UK subscribers, come here. Let me take a break from this Christmas wrapping bullshit. Let me show you what's in the cabinet. Since we're on a UK kick, I want to tell you guys, there it is. There it is. I told you. So many of you wrote me, oh, Alfred, that's not the proper Weetabix. Well, now I got the proper Weetabix. Weetabix. And after all this holiday hoo-ha, not rosy hoo-ha, but whatever, I'm going to unbox and boot the proper Weetabix for you guys in the UK. You asked for it. This is Alfred.tv at its finest, without any doubt. Make sure you stay tuned. More coming. And here we have a quite successful aluminum wrap with, of course, a touch of my industrial duct tape, just like, you know, for festive reasons. It looks good. It does. For Rich and Maria, I'm just giving them some money to put towards the new baby, Isabella. It's a baby fun gift. Let me show you how I'm wrapping the check. The check's gonna go in an Apple wireless Mighty Mouse box. I don't believe I bought this thing. I really don't like these rodential input devices from Apple. Look at how festive, subtle, and classy that looks. Isn't that great? This is innovative techniques, people. This is great stuff.
I really hope that these videos are inspiring you, are making you wrap your gifts to a whole nother level. I'd like to see video responses of how any of these videos, any of my videos, have helped influence how you wrap GIFs or JPEGs, whatever. Just going to skip that one and move forward because I'm running late once again. Ho, ho, ho. That's what Santa Claus said, but he saw the three hookers. Ho, ho, ho.
How nice. And look at this. There's a subliminal computer joke to Cousin Rich. Because the label says ISA Belafonte, Isabella Fund, but ISA is International Society of Automation. They're the ones that create, like, standards in the computer industry. Whatever.
I have something to insert into the Christmas wrap video. I'm wrapping a birthday gift for my friend Robert's 5-year-old daughter, Nicole. Let me show you what I got her.
And I got Nicole a Hannah Montana doll. It's the Hannah Montana Stylin' Hanover Makeover Set. I think it has audio, too. Let's see.
So it's a Stylin' Hanover makeover set. I guess we get to make her over from a brand, which is Hannah Montana, G-rated Disney brand, to an R-rated Miley Cyrus brand, as she tries to get emancipated or divorced from her parents so she can hang out with Justin. Anyway, what's important here is the wrap job. Let me show you what we're doing.
We will be doing a Walmart condom bag wrap job, all right? And now, of course, thinking of Miley Cyrus and Justin, we certainly think of condom. But more important, though, when you see a Walmart, I want you to remember me. Why? Because when you cover up the W, you get Almart.
And I'd like you, my YouTube subscribers and my Twitter subscribers and my uStream viewers, whenever you're at your local Walmart and you have a digital camera with you, cover up that W, take a picture, and email it to me. Here's the email address. I want a collection of all the Almarts across the country. I think we'll make a really good montage. On to the wrapping. Okay, and it's done. Yes, it looks like crap. Do you want to see?
There it is. Yes, indeed, crap. Now, you may be laughing because there's a significant amount of overhang over here, but you know what the overhang is?
I did it on purpose. It acts like a freaking handle. Don't break my shoes about this. But look at what else I did.
If you notice, I actually color coordinated the purple bow with the highlights of purple in the paper. So I think overall, this is pretty good. The kid's gonna love it. It's a personal gift. Wow, that's really a lot of overhang and it's ripping here. I'm gonna have to put some duct tape on this side. Whatever, I gotta go, I'm running late.
There you have a Hannah Montana Walmart condom Almart wrap job. More to come, stay tuned. Mike and Dorothy and family just moved into a new home this holiday season, so I'm just giving them some money that they can use as a housewarming gift. But I want to show you the card that I'm putting the check in. Check it out.
Okay, here's the Christmas card. All right, but take a close look. Santa's coming out of the fireplace there. All right, but take a close look. Look at his expression. And you tell me, looking at his expression and his body language there, that this card reeks of the expression, I just took a crap in your fireplace. Look at it. Look at it. Look at his face.
Santa left a duke in that person's fireplace. Anyway, let me show you the final collection of gifts because I'm done and I'm late and I gotta get to the freaking party.
Look at this lineup. Will you look at this? This is Holiday Wrap 2008. Innovative techniques for gift wrapping that is eco-friendly. Is this a riot? Is this great?
I gotta be honest with you. I really fear every time I make this video that I'm not gonna come up with new ideas. But from some magical reason, maybe it's the magic of Christmas, or maybe it's the stroke, I do. So anyway, this is for you. You all asked for it. You got it. Christmas Holiday Wrap 2008. More to come. This is Alfred.TV. I want to wish you all, my YouTube, Ustream, and Twitter subscribers, a very Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy whatever you celebrate. It doesn't matter. All right? Just stay safe, have fun, and pray that we all have a good, healthy, and profitable 2009. It's going to be a rough one, guys and gals. Big question mark on 2009. Everyone's going to have to strap in. But anyway, listen, wishing you the very best from Alfred.tv. Thank you for tuning in. I appreciate it. And I got to go reshower and get ready for the party because I am late. But I'm sure I'll film some footage at the party. So more to come. Stay tuned. Thanks a lot. Peace. Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho.
I got industrial tape on my card. Is that a furry hair out?
Yeah, probably. Dave, you like my aluminum foil?
I love it.
I love the aluminum foil.
Or is it aluminum for my UK subscribers?
Don't put it in the microwave.
There's no drugs in there. There's no drugs in there. And.
Like that means drugs.
The only drugs in the house are from you with your quadruple freaking bypass.
I have a bag full.
I like the ISA Bella Fund.
Oh, you like
that? No one else in this entire room gets it.
Sabrina,
yeah.
You like Elmo? It's an look. It's an Asian hooker Elmo, though.
Oh my God! You've got an Asian hooker in here.
It's up in the room. What is that?
Oh, come on! Didn't you see the label? The label said Asian hooker Elmo.
Yeah.
And Fran, that's Nancy's gift.
I know, but I'm not easy.
You're gonna help her open it with your arthritic fingers too?
Yeah.
Oh, you see, it looks like you're having a little trouble here, Fran.
I am. What the kind of tape did you put on?
It's industrial strength duct tape. It's from the Gorilla Company. It's supposed to be difficult for you guys. Oh, Nancy, you're never gonna open it with your one. Look at that.
Wait.
Oh, the YouTube crowd's gonna love watching this. It really is hard, isn't it?
Yeah.
Should we get her a knife, maybe? And she couldn't miss and slice a baby. You got it. Oh, you got to cheat now, Alex. Oh, take all the fun out of it, Alex. You're no fun.
I was hoping Grandma was going to pull it out of her backside.
Why? She carries
been even better.
Why? She carries a knife?
You don't know, Grandma.
Just don't slip and, like, you know, cut me. How long would it have taken your mother to open it?
You would have been here till tomorrow morning. At least.
Really?
Or maybe you could have saved it for next year by the time she got it open.
She would have tried to save the wrapping on it.
That's one thing about the gifts I wrap. No one saves the wrapping on the piece of crap that I wrap it with. Nice. Oh, Alyssa. My little angel. Oh, have I got a present for you. A special one from Santa.
That's not yours, sweetheart. Honey. That's not yours.
Uh-oh.
Come on, Alyssa. Come and get your gift.
That's Alyssa's.
You've been such a good, obedient, patient,
brat.
Healthful
brat.
Little girl.
I call him brat.
I call him a brat.
Yeah, brat.
What does it say?
Yummy wrap.
I'm going to do it myself.
Oh, it's a yummy wrap.
He may have too easy to open somewhere else.
What, there's industrial duct tape on there.
Yeah, but it's on the paper.
What do you got there?
Somebody's got a wing.
It's a fruitcake.
Fruitcake. You got fruitcake.
You think it's mean? Liz, what do you think?
Can we open this up for later?
Wait.
This is the one I gave you last year.
Knock it off. Camille, you think that's mean?
That was rotten. Wasn't just mean. That was rotten.
Wait till you see the real gift.
Oh, okay.
It's old fruitcake, too.
Uh-oh. It's got a handle on it.
That could be a bad sign.
Whoa!
Holy crap.
She's handling that a little too easy.
Liz, that's nicer than if you read that from the house.
Alyssa, careful, it's fragile.
I'm gonna hear him on the night.
there.
What is it?
Oh, that is cool.
It's the Wii, baby. Wii!
Merry Christmas, sweetheart.
She got the Wii box, it wasn't the Wii. She gets the Iron Man box, it's the Wii.
That was a double nested scam, Ange.
Yep, it was a good one.
It was pretty good. You're welcome, Merry.
Really threw her.
Merry Christmas, sweetheart. Did I confuse you?
She didn't know what it looked like. She was like, what is this? What the hell is this?
Yeah, there's another half in the Armani bag, so enjoy that. Oh, and Alyssa, if your grades at school suck, your parents take it away. All right, so keep the grades up, all right? Maria, am I right?
Yes, absolutely.
There you go. Now, and it's on film, and everyone on YouTube knows, all right? Take care. Merry Christmas, sweetheart. You're welcome. You're leaving?
Yes.
And where are you going?
What? I gotta go.
You're gonna meet who?
My brother.
You're going to the strip club. Oh, you're so full of crap.